Yes, of course. So my name is Ma Clare Lang. I am from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. So I'm part of the Calgary Sangha. I have been a disciple of His Divine Holiness, Shri Nithyananda Swami, since 2011. And I've been just, this past year has been amazing with everything that's happened and all the boons we've been receiving and all the Bhava Darshans. And I'm employed as a sales trainer, a corporate sales trainer, and just recently actually opened my own company a month ago. And it's been really great so far. So lots of blessings and boons have been coming my way, and I've been showered and so fortunate and lucky.
Wow, that's amazing, Ma. So, Ma, can you share a little bit about what you do and about your experience with Devi Parashakti?
Absolutely. So first of all, what I do is I am a sales trainer, so a lot of times I'm just going into different businesses and I am training their employees. And what's interesting is that I'm always, I'm a Kalpataru Acharya. So Swamiji, you know, a while back had initiated me as an Acharya, and I always end up teaching some part of Kalpataru in business, which they love. And it's funny, I had never really had a connection with Mother Energy. It was the thing that I was the least connected with. And I had a very difficult relationship with my mother. So when Devi first started manifesting, I didn't feel connected right away because it was something foreign for me. Swamiji, yes. Kalavedava, yes. Any type of male energy, instantly. Right? But Devi energy for me, I was unsure. Uh-huh. And it was only the, you know, this is the second time I've received blessings from Devi, and it was after the first time, see, I start to tear up now that I think of her. The first time I received blessings from her, that's when I finally, for the first time in my life, felt that divine feminine energy and that divine motherly love, which I had not experienced before. And so that, even in itself, beyond anything else that I've received, has been the greatest gift, is to feel that connection that I've been missing my whole life. So that's been very intense for me since Devi's been manifesting.
Alma, that's beautiful, Ma. So can you share a little bit about how you felt when you were seeing Swamiji every single day, how he's been attending to every single disciple, every single devotee, you know, giving them blessings that they didn't even know that they needed or wanted necessarily, and attending, I mean, personally, you've experienced so much of healing and so much of wealth manifestation. And how did that make you feel?
So Swamiji has always been so grateful. I've been so grateful for him, and he's provided me with so many, I have so many stories, but you know, the ones recently, so the first one I'll share again for those that missed, is when I had that first experience with Devi blessing. I was you know, I had YouTube on in the at the time, and I was just watching Devi Darshan, and I was working at the same time and sort of going back and forth between the two, and I had this intense feeling to just message in YouTube. And so I was writing the message, and at first I thought, it's Devi, you're not connected with that energy. Why should she respond to you? You know, like, she doesn't know who you are, and it's on YouTube. She can't even see you. You know, you're just watching from afar. It's not even on two-way. Why would she?
All your logic.
Right, right. The logic is telling me, like, there's no way. So she ended up, I had asked for her blessings, because Swamiji had told me a while back. He said, Ma Claire, you're going to be a Kalta, and that's what you're going to be, and I'm going to set you up for that.
Wow.
So I've been waiting for that experience. And so I finally asked her, I was like, okay, I'm just going to ask. I said, Ma Devi, you know, can you bless me for this to manifest? And something happened at work and I wasn't able to listen to any response, and I had to go, and I focused on work. Mm-hmm. That evening, I actually ended up in the hospital.
And,
I went through a life-threatening situation that evening. But what was interesting, and will make a very long story short, is I had been using pain medication for over a year and a half. I'd been in a car accident, and I'd been using pain medication, And it finally had such a detrimental effect on my body that my stomach stopped working.
Oh,
and
God.
So I ended up in the hospital. My stomach was not functioning and they were trying to get it back to function. And because of that, being in the hospital, I was in there for 5 days. They had to take me off all of that pain medication and I went through a detox and all that. But it's been, let's see, what's the date? It's been 6 weeks or something that I have not taken one pain pill.
Wow.
And I didn't know that she had blessed me. So it wasn't until I got out of the hospital that Mayanatma calls and says, Ma, you know, did you know that Ma Devi had blessed you? I heard you were in the hospital. And I was like, I was wondering if anyone was concerned about me. Like, I was in the hospital, I told you people, and no one says anything to me. I'm like, what's going on? And she said, Nah, because Devi blessed you, and that happened that night, so we all knew.
Wow.
Okay, so I never asked for that healing. I asked for Kalpa, and her blessing was that she would give me the mind, wisdom, money, and life in order to manifest Kalpa life.
Wow. And
the first thing was healing me from needing that pain medication.
Yeah. And you said it was for a year that you were on this medication?
A year and a half. And,
oh, wow.
It was opioid, so it was codeine. So,
oh my gosh.
Yeah, so
it was a major detox for you then.
Like, trying to get off that stuff by yourself.
Yeah.
Imagine. But it was only through her blessing that she made that happen, and it was in 5 days. And I was in the hospital, and I had all the medical care and treatment that I needed. And it's only when I came out that I found out that that was her blessing. Because at first, you know, didn't quite understand. And as soon as I heard that, I was like, oh, she saved me.
And my God.
She saved my life. And then then, although I haven't been on pain medication, I was still experiencing migraines, intense migraines.
Mm-hmm.
So I knew not to take the pain medication, and I was free of that addiction and need to feel like I needed to take medication for it. But I'd been struggling. And so last night I was again sitting for Devi Darshan, and this time I'm just enjoying Devi because I now feel this connection and I'm loving and all that. And I thought, should I ask about the migraines? And at first, again, my brain saying, no, she's already given so much, right? She's already done so much for you. I shouldn't ask for anything else, right? And then I just had this overwhelming feeling, just ask Ma. Like, even if she doesn't respond, you know she hears you. She responds. So I said, okay. So I put it in the chat and asked for blessings. And when she, when she called my name and blessed me again, I was just overwhelmed. It was instant tears, instant tears. And immediately I had such intense pain and pressure. Like, it was a very short amount of time, but it was like she was putting all of it through all at once that needed to be cleared. And she just intensely, I had this intense feeling in my head, and I can feel it tingling now in that same spot even as I think about it. And I just instantly, I remembered another devotee that said, when Devi gave healing and someone called and followed up and said, hey, are you healed? His response was, of course I am. Devi blessed it. Of course
yes.
I am. And I remembered that.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Uh-huh.
Devi blessed it. That means I'm healed.
Wow.
And so I've felt that ever since. And normally I would have some sort of headache today at all. So I do not at all. And so I'm glad I asked. And I guess my message to everybody is, she's there. And Swamiji said, you know, she's not granting boons, she's manifesting your reality.
Absolutely.
That has been my experience.
Wow. So has she healed you of opioid dependency and healed you of your migraines?
Yes.
With barely just even one message.
Yes. Like, and on top of that, the part I left out, because so many things have happened, that first blessing for Kata, I manifested $50,000 that same week. $50,000 that same week manifested.
Oh my God.
Her blessing, yes. And today, I also got a phone call from the government. I had been in a, I have an employment claim that's been stuck for 4 weeks now. And then all of a sudden they called me personally, the government of Canada, by the way, if you're in Canada, you know, trying to get a hold of the government of Canada is nearly impossible. The government called me We're so sorry your case has been held up. I've put it through and I've passed everything, and now you can go ahead and you'll receive the money you've been waiting for.
Wow. So
even though I didn't ask for anything like money, and just showers. So
that's amazing. And it's instant. Like, you just asked and within 1 week, like, you got you received such a huge boon.
Yes. And even just to be here, I literally ended work the second I'm here now. Like,
wow,
it aligns perfectly. And you said something really important that I've been experiencing so much, which is that instant response. Since Devi's blessing, I find now if I ask Devi or Swamiji, instant, someone calls me, sends me something, like, it is instant cosmic response. There's not even like a second delay.
Absolutely. It's like a real life, real solution immediately.
It's unbelievable. And just do not miss. Like, you cannot miss this. You have to be there. And even if it's on YouTube and you're just watching one way, don't think that nothing's happening in the channel. Don't even know you're there. I've had the experience now, right, twice, where that is.
Absolutely. And something you didn't even ask for, you got.
Right? Like, physical healing twice now. Like, the first one, wow, I was physically healed without asking. I never thought that.
And that's a huge thing. An opioid, like, dependency is not something easy to come off of. It's amazing that without even you asking or you telling baby that she was able to just immediately heal.
Yes. And the cognition, because I didn't realize it either. That's the thing. Sometimes when you're in addiction, you don't even realize to the degree that you've been abusing your body and using medication, because it was prescribed. So in my mind, I don't have a dependency, it's prescribed. But I absolutely had a dependency. And it was like, I think it was either I was going to lose my life or someone was going to pull me out. That's really how I feel, because of the degree to which I was taking all of that medication and for so long.
Yeah.
So she absolutely saved my life without a doubt.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yes.
So how did, you know, having experienced your own life-saving experience, how does it make you feel when you see Swamiji continuously attending to you and every single being who, during this COVID pandemic, like every single being, like not even asking, and they're just receiving so many blessings and boons?
For me, I always thought like, oh, I had to do something to deserve it. And here's the thing, you don't. You just have to be available. And available and open, and you just sit. The healing happens. And even if you don't ask, he tends to it. There are so many beings that are suffering on the planet so badly, and yet he's tending to my, you know, so-called little things in life, like every little thing he's tending to. There's so many big problems in the world.
Absolutely.
He's dealing with all of the big problems, but yet still, through his compassion and love, he still tends to even the smallest request that I have.
Absolutely.
Even if I want like a treat, and I just ask for a little treat, he gives and just
shows
everything. So it's, there's nothing more precious or sacred in life. There's no money, there's no relationship, there's no nothing that can compare to having that attention and love and care from an avatar.
Like, from ParamaShiva himself, yes.
There's nothing else that can compare to that. And I'm always just feeling overwhelmed with, what could I have possibly done to deserve this and to be able to sit here and
experience? It's just his compassion, Ma, his grace to attend to every single person, to attend to humanity and save the lives of so many people and during such a time of need. I mean, whether it's wealth manifestation or healing or opening up his home, his adinam for humanity to save their life and attend to their needs and provide a safe space and protective environment for quarantine. It's just, he attends to every single being in every single way that they need to be attended to, even if they don't realize it.
Yes. And I think that's such an important point too, is even if they don't realize it, right?
Like, yeah.
It's, there's so many beings that end up, you know, in front of Swamiji and don't even realize what's happened. Don't even know what's happened and what's hit them, right?
Absolutely.
It's mind-blowing. And I I've recently got into TikTok and started a TikTok channel.
Uh-huh.
And I've been enriching through TikTok, and just the people that will come on TikTok and see my video and just see the multi, and all of a sudden be like, I instantly cried. Like, I was instantly connected and I instantly cried.
Wow, that's amazing.
And there's so many people that are getting connected just by seeing his multi, and their beings are just, you know, they're just crying out for that connection. And
absolutely.
When we were talking about the expansion of the universe yesterday, right? And all uh-huh. the beings that are just flooding the earth in order to just be a part of this happening. Like, you're here right now. Do not miss it. Like, just go and sit and watch YouTube, and he'll take care of the rest. You don't have to do anything else. You just sit and watch, and you'll be attended to and taken care of.
Exactly. Yes. And it's like, it's so beautiful to see how, even though during this whole pralaya, this whole crisis that's happening, how his, Swamiji's devotees and disciples and followers are still having so much of breakthrough and having so much of peace and comfort and everything that they need in their life, despite so much of things happening in this world.
Yes, it's such a different experience for a disciple, from what I've seen, than from other human beings, unfortunately. And I had always suffered intense anxiety the majority of my life, and mm-hmm. had panic attacks and all that. So I thought, oh God, like, when this pandemic hits, what's going to happen to me? Nothing happened to me. Like,
you're getting so many breakthroughs and healing.
I've never been in a better spot in my life. Like, I've never had more money. I've never had more healing. I've never had more, you know, peace. And yes, I'm going through my patterns that happen, like we all do, but at the mm-hmm. very state and space, I know I'm well taken care of. I'm not fearing anything. I know who's there holding me, and that he's just guiding me through this whole thing. And, you know, not being a part of that collective fear, not having that same fear, is such a blessing and such a state to be in, where I'm in the space of enriching other human beings versus in the state of fearing and shrinking. I'm expanding in a time of great intensity. I never thought would be possible in my life. There was a time where I couldn't
leave with Swamiji.
Right? There was a time where I couldn't leave my house. I was so scared of life.
Wow.
I could not leave my house.
Wow.
And now I'm in a space of, in a pandemic, I'm like, who can I enrich today? And
Wow.
Unbelievable transformation from where I originally came from in 2011 to where I am now. I never, ever could have ever thought I'd even get close to where I am now as a human being. Like, completely different person. Yeah. So, yeah, amazing.
Why do you feel that people need Swamiji at this time in their life, you know, especially with the whole pandemic, everything that's going on in the world?
So for me, what's really changed my cognition is that someone's responsible for me. And mm-hmm. that is such a huge weight off my shoulders when I think, how am I going to do this? How is, you know, life going to support me? How am I going to support my family? I don't think that. I just automatically know Swamiji's responsible for me. And
you're taking care of.
It's the taking care of piece, knowing that there's something bigger than yourself that is driving and carting the ship. And all you have to do is sit and be available to receive mm-hmm. blessings and boons. Like, it's that piece. It's every time I get scared about something, I said, Swamiji's responsible, and he immediately just drops for me.
Wow.
So
wow.
People having that in their life, I think that's the root of so many fears, is feeling like someone's not there to take care of you. And and if you get that connection and you feel that caring, it just allows you to relax and go through life smoothly rather than in intense fear like the majority.
Especially at a time like this when people don't know who to trust, you know, whether it's the media or doctors, because people don't really have information. And, you know, even if they do, there's a certain point where even doctors can't help, even, you know, whatever best medical care can't help. Only having an avatar, only having Swamiji in your life can really give you that insurance and give you that protection in your life.
Yes. And there's no, you know, there's nothing behind it. right? He's not asking for anything in return. Right. So media is asking for attention, government's asking for money, business is asking for money, doctors, bless their souls, but they also are getting paid, right?
Absolutely.
He is asking nothing. He's asking, sit in front of me so I can bless you and
I can give you booze.
Right? So not having an agenda is what makes this different and why, you know, I have such trust in him, is there's no agenda there. He just wants to take
Absolutely.
Care of me. Who's going to say no? Absolutely. Don't take care of me.
Right. And especially like it's kind of crazy to see how, you know, there are organizations and people profiting off of this pandemic and this crisis, and, you know, whether it's governments or businesses or whoever, there are certainly people who are profiting off of this. And even if they might be providing some kind of service, you don't know that you can necessarily trust them because they have an agenda, like you said. But Swamiji is just here to shower and give boons and blessings and take care of humanity.
Yes. Like, how can you say no to that or not trust that?
Like, yes.
And that's the thing, is that you just sit there once and then the proof starts happening. Right? He even gives Absolutely. Us the proof. You know, we shouldn't want to be asking for the proof, and he even gives us the proof. He says, okay.
Exactly. Like, exactly. All you have to trust is your own experience. Thank you so much, Ma. Thank you so much for coming and sharing enlightening all the viewers with your personal experience. And, you know, I can see that a lot of people are connecting with you and your experiences. So thank you so much for your time, Ma.
Thank you, Ma. It was a pleasure as always, and blessings to everyone.
Thank you so much, Ma.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.